In this illustration, we'll analyze the maximum compression in a spring. Here the figure shows a block of mass 2 kg moving on a frictionless surface at a speed 1 meter per second toward another identical block fitted with a spring of force constant 100 newton per meter. We are required to find the maximum compression of a spring during motion of blocks. Here in solution we can see when the block will hit the spring, it will start transferring momentum from first block to the second, and at the time of maximum compression and spring, both the blocks would be moving at equal speeds. This we already discussed in concept videos. Here we can write, at the point of maximum compression in a spring, both blocks will be moving at equal speeds, which we can write say V, then we can say by conservation of momentum. Here we can write initial momentum of the system was 2 multiplied by initial speed is 1 meters per second is equals to final velocity is say V for both the blocks, then the total mass is 4, so this will be 4 multiplied by V, which gives us the final velocity that is equals to 0.5 meters per second when the compression in a spring is maximum. Now by energy conservation, here we can write initial kinetic energy of the block was half multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 square. Finally, the total energy of system must be equal to the kinetic energy of initial block. So it can be written as half multiplied by K of a spring is 100 multiplied by x max square plus the kinetic energy of blocks would be 2 multiplied by half multiplied by 2 multiplied by 0.5 square, which is the speed at the time of maximum compression in the spring. On simplifying this relation, here you can see several terms can be directly simplified, and the value of xm square we are getting is 1 minus 0.5 by 50, which is equals to 1 by 100. Further, it gives the value of xm is equals to 1 by 10, that is 0.1 meter, or it is 10 centimeter. That is the final result of this problem, the maximum compression in the spring.